Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, Dhul Hijjah is nearly over. Or first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah is nearly over. The Hujjaj are going to finish their Hajj. Are you making the best of it? Are you fasting on the day of Arafat? Or have you fasted? Have you prepared yourself to fast on the day of Arafat? I'm hoping you will be, or you are. Let me now go to the next verse. Surah Saffat, Surah 37, verse number 109. Salamun ala Ibrahim. Peace be upon Ibrahim. Allah says that in the Quran. Ibrahim surrendered. Ibrahim submitted. Ismail did the same. They were prepared to sacrifice and be sacrificed. And Ibrahim and Ismail were rewarded. So Allah says, Salamun ala Ibrahim. May peace be upon Ibrahim. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Allah is saying this about Ibrahim. May Allah's peace be upon Ibrahim. When we do tahiyyat, remember what Allah says in the earlier verse, that generations will remember him and Allah's peace will be on him. Look at what we do. At tahiyyat we say, what do we say? At tahiyyat lillahi wa salawat. And at the end, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Ya Allah, bless our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just like you blessed Prophet Ibrahim and his family. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. O Allah, have your blessings, your barakah on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family, just like you gave barakah to Prophet Ibrahim and his family. Subhanallah. Ongoing dua until the day of judgment. That's what Allah means. Salamun ala Ibrahim. Peace be upon Ibrahim. May Allah bestow his peace on Ibrahim. Ibrahim has been given the highest of accolades, highest of status. And you and I need to understand, when you sacrifice, when you surrender, when you connect with Allah, you will also be blessed and you will also be living in peace on this earth and in the hereafter. Not only you, your family will be doing the same. Allah Azza wa Jal keep us like this. Then he says, كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Thus we reward the doers of good in the same way. Anyone who does good, we give them rewards. Muhsineen are those who are good. Again, Ibrahim, Ismail, and those who follow their path have been defined and described by Allah in the Quran as muhsineen, people who do good. And when you do good, Allah will reward you, inshallah. Last verse for my reflection on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam's life. Verse number 111 from Surah Saffat, Surah 37. Innahu min ibadina al-mu'mineen. Allah says, innahu, surely he was, truly one of the believing servants. Allah gives certificate about Ibrahim. Innahu min ibadina al-mu'minin. Surely he was amongst those who are true servant of Allah, who are amongst our true servants. Now, if Allah certifies somebody as his true servant, it doesn't matter anymore. Nothing else matters. You've succeeded. Shouldn't that be your goal, my brothers and sisters? On the day of Arafat, as the Hujjaj are gathering to ask Allah for forgiveness, I hope you will be fasting, or you've been fasting and asking Allah for forgiveness. You'll be asking Allah, saying, Ya Allah, forgive me. Accept me as your true servant. Enable me to surrender in your way. If Allah guarantees you that you have surrendered, then you truly have surrendered. And if Allah says you are truly a believer, then there is no doubt about your belief. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam's belief is not in doubt. So to summarize what I've said so far, Ibrahim established the truth by searching for it. So he was known as Hanifa, the searcher. Ibrahim was mild-mannered, known as Al-Halim. Allah's name is Al-Halim. He was known as Halim. His son Ismail was also Halim. Ibrahim discovered the truth because Allah showed him the truth. He invited his people to the truth. He stood up to his people gently and politely, but they punished him. He succeeded in their punishment. He came out unscathed. He argued with the king of the country and won the argument. And the king of the country was destroyed. And yet the people did not believe. So he left them. He left them. He asked Allah when he left them, Ya Allah, guide me, and Allah guided him. Allah, give me a son. Allah gave him a son, a righteous son. Allah gave him a righteous son. They surrendered together. And Allah gave them a certificate of success. Isn't that the most profound stories of success, of surrender, and recognition by Allah? If you want to be recognized by Allah, follow the same path. The path of Ibrahim, path of Ismail, path of Musa, Isa, path of all the prophets, and certainly the path of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah have mercy on you all. May Allah forgive us all. May Allah guide us to His path and keep us on it. Give us the strength to be able to dedicate our lives in His path, totally submitted, surrendered to His will, prepared to sacrifice, and most importantly, willing to be tested. And when we have been tested and succeeded, Allah will reward us with rewards that we cannot imagine. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.